Okay, hi all. So technically this is a few days later, but as when I'm sending them to YouTube, it'll be like just yesterday. Okay, so I had already did the video, y'all know, pre-prepping this, meaning I painted and then I did my thin coat of E6000. You'll always know because see how shiny that is. And then people, like I said, I like to try to explain in the details. The reason why this is different than if it had just, let me get this controlled out, just this little clear topping coat, the difference between them is because that glue give it that grip. You get what I'm saying? And as I progress, I don't have to worry about the colors bleeding or any of that, because like I said, the E6000 and the marker paint go hand in hand, where like you saw in the video, as I was applying this, you didn't see it smearing into any of the other colors, and I love that. And I want to also, I didn't do the hill because I wanted you to see why, another reason why I pre-prepped, excuse me, I just unplugged the light. Come on, light, don't beat this light. You got to be gentle with the light. But I left this standalone with just the primer because I wanted you to see this. Okay. Because I wanted to do new videos just explaining more in details. Because you know how you look back on other videos and you're like, for me, I felt like I didn't explain it better. And I don't know. I just take the time because, like I said, I know how hard it is and frustrating it gets sometimes when you really want to learn something. But it, I don't know if y'all are like me. It was much harder for me to learn. But once I got it, baby, I got it. Okay, and so yeah, like I said, I cut these into strips. Now I'm going to show you how it would be with this on this surface compared to here. Now, putting them on there. Now, even if I put heat on there, this surface, even like if it was the original surface, just this, it's not staying on there. It's going to come up. It's going to come up. Now, see when I put it on here? And like I said, this is just E6000 that's been dry. But because that changes that consistency, it changes the surface, excuse me, not the consistency. It's a whole nother ball game. It's a whole, and this is before you even, I even apply heat. I don't have to worry about, oh, I wonder if it's going, It's a whole different type of stick. Now I'm going to just cut this because you see the line right there, so you already know that means I'm going to be going that way with this. Move you over, save all your extra. But do you hear that? I should have did that with this one, but you're with this, it would have peeled off. See this? It give it that, and then you go, and then what you do? Hit it with that heat. Lock them in there. That's like just if you want to just add this trim. Because I'm going to be adding stones, I'm already going to be sealing them sides with the E because I'm going to be applying stones. And then, like I said, I'll still apply heat. And you go, but these are jellies. These are plastic. You cannot apply heat. Didn't I show y'all? Yes, you can by using that what? That transfer heat resistant paper. Put that on top there. I'm still hitting this with the heat. But, so yeah, I wanted to just quickly explain that to you all and just show you that. Look how cute, y'all. Come on, y'all know this is gonna be cute. And I even love how it looks just painted. I feel like it looks like one of those artsy, you know, paintings. I just like stuff like this. And look, I had to blow the dust off my headphones, y'all, because why? Because I miss wearing these. And yes, I'm about to start wearing these in the park. But for my realist members, y'all remember when I did this? Remember Kitty Kitty? Remember Kitty Kitty? Okay, let me stop moving it around because people are like, we can't remember if we can't see it. But yeah, these are my kitty headphones. I got these in white and I got them in black. And what I love about them is, well, they kitty ears, they cat ears, and they light up if I've charged them, but y'all know. Oh, yeah, yeah. So I don't know if you can be able to see how they look, and I'm trying to remember because y'all know it's been a long time since I used to have it where they would switch. Well, you know, because they change colors, but it used to do like that ombre thing, but I don't remember much. That's how you know it's been a long time. But I'm gonna cut the light off so you can see what I'm talking about. There you go. I don't know. Ooh, yes. See? And they usually flip from color to color. I gotta remember which buttons do all that, because they got a bunch of different buttons. As y'all can see, I don't remember. I don't know. So yeah, I just wanted to show that right quick for no apparent reason but to go licky licky. Oh, now I want to blink different color. See? That's why I can't mess with you. I don't want to turn you off. No, it's too late now. They don't want to see it. So yeah, I wanted to just show that really quick, explain this, and now I'm gonna get to the blinging. And y'all, look how gorgeous this look. Come on now. Ooh, you telling me y'all ain't in love with that transparent? It's like, let me just bring it close. Just in. You smell that? Do you smell that? Oh, wait. I also forgot one more thing. And I know you like, you keep forgetting. But another reason why I love jellies and that they're so different from using glass stones is because you can do what? Now, I'm not going to use these big ones, but I usually use some smaller stones. Say you want them to fit like that perfect fit, you know, honeycomb or whatever. A lot of times you have to use the different sizes. I don't know if people actually acknowledge that. They'll use like SS12s and SS10s. The outer will be like SS12s, the inner will be SS10s because they're so close in size but different. They're able to make that fit like perfect. Don't know if you know that. But with these, do you see that? And no, it does not mess up the quality of them. Look. Can you see that? Still gorgeous. And then look. Do you see how you make that fit perfectly on that end? Turn it around. And that, look. You get that? Okay. So, yes, I wanted to show that. And, okay, now, on to what? Fast forward. Hi all, really quickly, I decided to do the trim work around the top and the bottom as well, and I just wanted to show, hopefully you'll be able to see it. Do you see where I do a layer of E6000 around the top? Now it doesn't slide to the stones because you see the stone quality is still beautiful, but that's sealing them on the top. And then when I do the E6000 on here, that's also going to seal it here. And so, of course, that means they're not going to lift up or come off because I've locked them in bottom, sides, and both sides. So I wanted to just show that really quick before I start on this. And I decided to start with the champagne color because I want to go from left to right instead of going middle up. You get where I'm going with y'all. So I'll be doing that. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, hi y'all. This Patreon patron shout out goes to Jolene's Exclusive Designs, DLH, Not My Daddy, Ms. Diamond, Cezanna, Reggie, and Ernestine. Thank you all for supporting me and believing in my dream. And also, here are the rest.